Good day, welcome. This is your Daily Med with Lady V. Today we want to pay attention to what the scripture says in Psalm 122, verse 6, and we will read to verse 9. We are encouraged to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Psalm 122 and verse 6 says, "Greet Jerusalem with peace. They shall prosper who loves you. Peace be within your walls and prosperity within your palaces. For my brethren and companions' sake, I will say, peace be within you. For the sake of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek your good." So what is the psalmist saying? Here he is saying, if we pray for this place, which is Jerusalem, may you prosper. Having come to Jerusalem to worship, the psalmist looked at the city, the place where God put his name. He admired the city, prayed for its peace and prosperity, and invited others, you and me, such as will do as well. Ask the Lord, he says, for peace in that place. And he says, those who do so will be blessed. In prophecy, as well as in history, there is an ocean of meaning in this plea. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. This is what the psalmist plead, and he himself prayed. A place whose name mean peace, but there is no peace there. And even darker days lies ahead. The narrow streets of the city will echo to the tread of Gentiles invaders until the Prince of Peace, Israel's Messiah, returns to assume the reign of the throne and the reign of government. St. Luke 21 and verse 24. Isaiah 9 verse 6 and 7 tells us, Isaiah prophesied about Christ. He says to us in Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6 and verse 7, he says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be up on his shoulder, and his name is to be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty One, the Everlasting God, the Prince of Peace." He says, Of the increase of his government and of his peace, there shall be no end upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to establish it and to sustain it with justice and with righteousness from henceforth, even forever. The zeal of the Lord will perform this. So here Isaiah prophesied about Christ in his first advent when he came to earth as a babe. He says the government will be up on his shoulders, for of course he shall rule and reign on the throne of David upon the earth in this special place that we are praying about for 1,000 years in the millennial rule. So peace in the city of peace. Peace will be there when the King of Peace comes to reign. David was saying, may those be at peace who love her. May those be at peace who pray for her peace. May the benediction of peace rest upon those who love the city of the great King. How do we express this love? We pray for all. We pray promoting tranquility, the Bible says, within its walls, and safety within its towers. Whatever, he says, these people require, or that which is required for Jerusalem. We know it's the Jew who worship there. Then this should be the desire of the church. Apostle Paul tells us in Ephesians 4 and verse 3. He says, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. So Jesus Christ himself informing, or Jesus Christ himself when he formed the church, God eliminated the great division that ever existed among human beings. And it is the rift between Jews and Gentiles. In Christ Jesus, these distinctions are abolished. It is Jesus Christ who gave his life for each individual, whether Jew or Gentile. And here the Apostle Paul in Ephesians chapter 4 is pleading for unity amongst Christians. The Holy Spirit has made all believers to be one in Christ. The body is indwelt by one Spirit, and this is the basic unity that nothing can destroy. Jesus Christ himself is the source of this peace. So he says we should keep the unity of the Spirit. It means that we should live at peace one with another. Peace is the ligament which binds the members of the body of Christ together. In spite of our wide natural differences, it is through the peace and prosperity of the church that blessings will flow out to the world at large. As mentioned already, the greatest glory in Jerusalem is the city. It is the house of the Lord that is there that makes this place great. And I'm sure we all know the story about Jerusalem. There is always a fight. There is always somebody else who wants to do something different from what God wanted there. But the Bible tells us that God has placed his name on this city. And it is the city that he has designated and decreed that his people would come to worship and to give him thanksgiving. It is the house of the Lord. So the central fact is that He chose this city as the site for the temple. The presence of the Lord cast an enormous amount of glory and splendor. When the pilgrims come to worship, they were joyful. David said, I was glad when they say unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Centuries later, Jesus had to remind the scribes and the Pharisees of this truth. They value the goal of the temple. But guess what? Not the temple itself. They value the gifts that they bring, but they don't pay attention to the altar in which they lay the gift. Jesus pointed out that this is the temple. Yes, it is the temple that is there. The temple is sacred, not so much the goal. It is the altar that sanctifies the gift that is brought. And so in today's world, we see men preferring the healing, but not wanting the healer. People want the deliverance, but they don't want the Savior. So the Lord himself is the one who sets Jerusalem apart from all other cities in his creation in the world. Remember what he says is his. And in fact, in Psalm 24, the Bible tells us the earth is the Lord's, the fullness thereof, and the world that dwell therein. He chose Israel as his chosen people. He has that right. He chose Jerusalem as the place where he placed his name and where his temple ought to be. The place where he will rule from David's throne. He has that right. The earth belongs to him and everything therein. But we are reminded today to pray for the place and the people whom he has chosen and the place where he chose to put his name. God bless you. Thank you again for watching. Please like, please subscribe, please share, also comment, and don't forget to visit my YouTube channel, Daily Med with Lady V.